So today I'm here to give a brief update on the Omicron variant of concern, and in particular, some of the sublineages that are circulating globally, and in particular, BA.4 and BA.5, as well as BA.2.12.1. So let's first start with an update of BA.4 and BA.5. And in particular, when we're looking at variants of concern or any variants circulating globally, what we're looking at is to determine if there's any changes in transmission, in severity, in immune escape, in reinfection, and of course, the impacts of our countermeasures such as diagnostics, therapeutics, and vaccines. So BA.4 and BA.5 have been detected in a number of countries. So far, there are a few hundred sequences that are available of both BA.4 and BA.5, but this will change as sequencing increases around the world. Most of the cases of BA.4 and BA.5 have been detected in South Africa. With regards to what may happen in other countries, it depends. It depends on a number of factors, including the population level immunity from vaccination and or past infection, as well as other sublineages of Omicron that are currently circulating. This is why it is really important that surveillance is maintained, if not enhanced, so that we can track these known variants that are circulating around the world. We are also evaluating the severity of BA.4 and BA.5. What we're looking at is, are there any increases in hospitalization among the cases that are detected with BA.4 and BA.5? It's still very early days with this. We are starting to see a little bit of an increase in hospitalizations in South Africa, but that's also due to the fact that we're seeing increases in cases. What experts are trying to determine is if this is due to BA.4 and BA.5. In addition to looking at severity in people, there are a number of studies that are also underway that are looking at severity in the lab. These studies are currently ongoing, and this is similar to what we do when we are trying to evaluate any of the variants that are circulating. As this information becomes available, we'll make this information available to you. As with all of the sublineages classified under Omicron, which is a variant of concern, there is some level of immune escape. There are some studies that are underway looking at the immune escape of BA.4 and BA.5 compared to other sublineages. What we can say at the present time is that it is really critical that people get vaccinated. Vaccines still work incredibly well against preventing severe disease and death. So when it is your turn, please get vaccinated. We also wanted to provide an update of an Omicron sublineage BA.2.12.1. As with all of the sublineages of Omicron, we are tracking transmissibility, severity, and immune escape, as well as impact on countermeasures. There are about a few thousand sequences available of this variant, BA.2.12.1, and there are many studies that are underway to evaluate this further. There's limited information that we have so far about this variant. Most of the sequences of this Omicron variant are identified in the United States. There is a slight growth advantage of BA.2.12.1 over BA.2, and so we expect more cases to be detected of this variant. So it's been more than 5 months since Omicron was classified as the variant of concern at the global level. And WHO and our partners are tracking many sublineages of this variant. The virus continues to evolve. What is really critical is that surveillance continues. And not only do people get tested and receive the clinical care that they need, but that we at WHO and our partners around the world are able to track the known variants of concern and all of their sublineages, as well as the detection of the possibility of new emerging variants of concern. So it is really critical that testing continues, that sequencing continues, and that there's good geographic representation of those sequences, that samples are shared, that isolates are shared so that research can be carried out so that we could better understand transmission, severity, immune escape, as well as the impact of our countermeasures. If we don't have sequencing continue, if we don't have surveillance continue, we will not be able to do this in real time. We will not be able to carry out the studies or be able to advise and make the best advice available to all of you who are out there. What we can say without question is that it is really important that you get vaccinated when it's your turn and receive the full course of those doses. Being vaccinated protects against severe disease and death, and it can keep you and your loved ones safe.